If you want more traffic on your website, the easiest way is to add more content on your website. But if you want to add more content on your website, you need to have ideas on what topics to write about on your website. But that's the challenge for most website owners. They forget, or they don't understand, or they don't realize what topics they can write about to get more traffic. So in this video, I'm going to talk about five of the easiest ways you can brainstorm or come up with ideas on how to write more and more content on your website to get more traffic. Let's go. The first and the easiest way to generate topic ideas for your website is to look at what's already working for other websites. Whether it's your competition or whether it's broad websites that write about a lot of different topics, you can figure out a lot of data, or you can figure out what topics are working by looking at what they're constantly publishing about. If it's your competition or other websites that publish in your niche, if they're constantly writing about a topic, covering the variety of topics in that particular, I'd say, silo or niche, or they're just updating the content regularly, keeping it up to date all the time, that's generally a sign that that topic or that silo or that group of topics is working well for them, bringing them revenue, bringing traffic, or bringing them sales, or whatever you are aiming for. So that's the easiest way you can get started. Not look at just your competition, also look at other websites who publish broad topics and figure out what topics they are writing about to get more inspiration. The next step you can take to find out even more blog topics for your website or blog is by using dedicated tools that are designed for keyword research or said research purposes. There are a lot of tools in the market. There's Ahrefs. We recommend SEMrush. There's a link down in the description. You can go check it out. There's also Answer the Public and other tools that you can utilize to find out more keyword ideas for your website. Most of the time, they will either fetch the data from Google Keyword Planner, but they also scrape data from Google or YouTube or other search engines like Amazon, where a lot of people make their searches. With the help of these tools, not only will you be able to figure out more topics that Google Keyword Planner won't give you, but you'll also understand what kind of usual keyword or what kind of questions people ask. A lot of these tools actually scrape their data, or I say collect this data and organize it and provide that to you in an easy to use manner. So not only will you be able to understand your customer or ideal customer better, you'll have actionable data on what blog post to write about, how to frame it, and what kind of questions users ask so that you can answer them effectively with your blog post. So not only is this a fantastic way to generate new topic ideas, but also understand your customers on a deeper level. What are they looking for? So even if you have a topic idea, you might answer a lot of different questions inside that specific blog post, which users will find very helpful. And of course, this will also ensure that you have a high probability of ranking in the search results because you're answering a lot of the different questions that users are actually looking for. So check these out. I'll leave some links in the description of this video. The next way you can generate even more blog post ideas for your website or blog is by using WPBeginner's blog post idea generator. It's a fantastic new tool, and here's how it's different from different keyword research tools out there. Most keyword based tools will give you ideas based on what you input in the tool itself. So if you input a set of seed keywords, the keyword tool gives you ideas based on that. So if you're missing a key piece of context in your niche, then you might never be able to find the related keywords regarding that context. That's the first problem. The second problem with this approach is that in a lot of topics or a lot of niches, many users don't know what they don't know. So if they don't know something, they'll never search for it. So there's no search traffic for it. But if you can find an interesting angle, interesting topic, interesting way of presenting information about your topic, many users will actually lap it up and find it very, very useful. You've seen this pattern emerge on social media already. On YouTube Shorts, Instagram Reels, and TikTok, users are not looking or searching for specific information, but they're consuming information in a lot of different topics because it's presented in a useful, entertaining way. So if you find these interesting topics from the WPBeginner's blog post idea generator, it'll give you a new way of thinking, new way of finding more seed keyword ideas, and more way of understanding how users might be able to consume the information even if they're not looking for it. So use the tool, it's fantastic. You just have to enter a couple of keywords and you'll get 30 or more ideas instantly that you can start utilizing and using on your website. And what you can also do is use this as inspiration to do more keyword research and find out if already people are searching for specific topics regarding what the suggestions are given to you by the blog post idea generator. So check it out, it's a fantastic new release. I'll link it in the description of this video. Go check it out and share some feedback in the comments. The next way to brainstorm more ideas is by using AI-related tools like ChatGPT. Now, before we get into the AI realm, let me clarify a few things. I don't endorse completely writing your content with AI, but AI is a fantastic tool to do custom research, identify topics that users are interested in, and it can cut down your research time in half or even less. So don't go to tools like ChatGPT and have the content written for you, because there are a lot of problems with that. But what you can do is ask ChatGPT to brainstorm ideas for you. So you can say, hey, what are people looking for when it comes to gardening? What are the common issues with gardening? What are the common questions users ask when gardening? So ChatGPT and other AI tools can take all the information available on the internet and figure out what users are asking questions in forums, on different websites, what questions have been answered, and it can cut down your research time significantly. So once you do get significant research done by ChatGPT, ChatGPT. You can use the other tools I've mentioned, like the WPBeginner blog post idea generator, the keyword research tools I mentioned, and you can plug that data in from ChatGPT to other tools and do even more research and find out actionable data on what users are actually searching for. And this will give you more context, more horizons to think about when it comes to your topic. And this will give you an edge over the competition because they might be already looking at what Google Keyword Planning is giving them, but you might be able to find out more questions that other websites or your competition is not looking for. So what do you think about this video? Leave your honest feedback in the comments. If you have any questions, comment section is where it is. And of course, you can share more ideas on what topics and what videos we should make in the comments as well. If you like this video, thumbs up would be appreciated. If you like content like this, make sure to subscribe. My name is Yuvraj. You're watching WP Beginner, and I'll catch you in the next video. Take care.